right. Well, here we go. Y'all ready to get it in? Well, we thank you, Lord. Let's all stand to our feet. We thank you for a hungry group of people. Come on, is anybody hungry for the Lord? Hallelujah. We thank you, Lord, for stirring up in us a hunger, Lord, to see your kingdom come and your will to be done. We thank you, Lord, as everyone is coming and they come into this atmosphere, Lord, they're going to be transformed and provoked by your glory, by your passion, by your heart, Lord. So we just thank you, Lord, stirring up our hearts. Jesus, have your way. Come on, can you just ask Jesus to have his way? Just have your way in each one of us. Come on, worship team, just ask the Lord to have his way in your heart today. Have your way, Jesus. We love you and adore. And thank you, Lord, for your appearing. We thank you, Holy Spirit, for your abiding. You abide in us. You abide in this place. We thank you for the rest of heaven, Lord. So we just thank you, Lord, as we come boldly before the throne room of God. Lord, we thank you for what you're going to release today. Come, Holy Spirit, even more. You abide, but we ask, come even more. More manifestations. Lord, we thank you for the healings this week that people were able to see. But we thank you, Lord, there's even more to come. Come on. The hungry hearts are always satisfied. The hungry hearts are always satisfied. So I just challenge each one of you in this room, as you prepare your hearts, as you prepare your praise makes habitation in your life. So increase even what you had last week. The praise you had last week, come on, just raise it up even higher. So we thank you, Lord. So I challenge you, come out of your seats, do something you haven't done before, and really just press in to the mark of the high calling which is in Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. Let's go. Hallelujah.
How amazing he is. How glorious he is. How wonderful he is. Oh, how exciting it is to serve Jesus. How exciting and wonderful it is to love our Father and to love our Daddy. Oh, we declare that we're yours today. We declare we're yours. So I shout out your name. From the rooftops I proclaim that I am yours. I am yours. And all that I am, I place into
I'm Sing that out. I know I'm loved. Whoa. I know I'm wanted. I know I'm loved. I know I'm wanted. I know I'm loved. I know I'm wanted. I know I'm loved. Yes, I'm
You are.
pounding at my door. Your love is pounding at my door.
Worship. I pray that you're hearing what he's saying. The Lord is an all-consuming fire. That's why he says, awaken, don't awaken love before it's time. See, we have to be ready to be consumed because love's going to consume every part of you. Love's going to consume every day in your life. And so as much as we want love, love wants us more. Come on, the Father wants you more than you could ever want him. He is all consumed with you. And he's asking, are you ready to be all consumed with me? Because when we get wrapped up in him, there's no more of us. It's just a beautiful us that we've never known and never seen. And then we look at ourselves and it's like we're brand new. Because indeed in Christ, we've been made brand new creatures. So this all-consuming fire, Lord, that's here today, we ask, Lord, that every person would be ready to step in. Come on, just do a prophetic act. If you're in the pews, just step to the side or step forward or raise your hands. Do a prophetic act and say, I'm stepping in. I'm stepping in. Like this new year, God, I'm coming in. I'm stepping in.
Stepping in the love, 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 stepping in your 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 love. echo Paul's prayer in Ephesians chapter 3, that you would give unto us according to the riches of your glory, to be strengthened with might by your spirit of love in the inner man, that Christ, who is love, may dwell in our hearts richly by faith, and that we be rooted and grounded in the love of God, and that we would be able to know with all the saints of God what is the breadth, the length, the height, and the depth, to know the love of Christ which passes knowledge, that we might be filled with all the fullness of who love.
We are, I'm after your heart, With your fire, desire, baptize my heart with your fire, desire, baptize my heart with your fire, desire, baptize my heart with your fire, desire. And I don't want to be offended. I don't want to be offended. I don't want to be.
to Jesus, and I pledge my allegiance to the Lamb. And I pledge my allegiance to Jesus, to Jesus. And I pledge my allegiance.
Come on and stand to your feet as we end this. Come on and tell the Lord I pledge.
I pledge my allegiance to Jesus, to Jesus.
Standing on their feet. If you pledge your allegiance, come on, tell it.
I pledge my allegiance to Jesus, to Jesus. And I pledge my allegiance to the Lamb.
One more time, yeah.
I pledge my allegiance to Jesus, to Jesus. And I pledge my allegiance to the Lamb.
I want to be for you. For you, not against you. I wanna be with you where you are.
I wanna be for you, not against you. I wanna be with you where you are.
One more time.
I'll be for you, not against you. I wanna be with you where you are.
I wanna be for you, not against you.
I wanna be with you where you are.
Jesus. Come on, everybody in this room. There's going to be a day when you're face to face. Face to face. With the one whose eyes burn like fire in love with you. And he's going to account every record of your life. And he's going to ask, how do you account this life that I gave you as a gift? And you're going to say, I thought it was just a trial. He's going to say, it was my gift to you. Who would you serve? How did you do? And what's the verdict? And you'll say, there's only one verdict. I pledged my allegiance to the Lamb. Come on. It's time the body of Christ learns to walk in obedience again. Yeah. Everybody remember that word? It was a word that the Lord gave when you first saw him, when you first understood him. He said, will you follow me? And you said, yes, I will. I'll follow you in all the things that I do. In all my ways, I'm going to acknowledge you. And you're going to direct my path. Because I know you have good intentions. Because you're a good, good father. And I give it all. I give it all. I give it all to you, Jesus. Come on, return to the Lord with all your heart. Return to the Lord with all your strength. Return to the Lord, all ye people of the land.
And I pledge my allegiance.
We pledge our allegiance, Jesus.
To Jesus. To Jesus, and I pledge my allegiance to the Lamb.
Come on, sing it with everything you have.
I pledge my allegiance to Jesus, to Jesus.
to Jesus, and I place my allegiance to the Lamb. And I pledge my allegiance to Jesus, to Jesus, and I pledge my allegiance to the Lamb. Jesus, and I pledge my allegiance to the Lamb. And I pledge my allegiance to Jesus, to Jesus, and I pledge my allegiance to the Lamb.
Somebody give God a shout.
Come on, God's raising up an unstoppable army. The question is, are you for him or against him? Come on, Joshua asked this very thing. Come on, you can turn the lights up. Joshua asked this very thing. He said, are you, angel, for us or against us? And the angel looked at Joshua and says, that's not the question. The question are you for us or against us? Because the angels of the Lord's army, the Lord of hosts himself, doesn't fight on our behalf. We fight on his behalf. And because we fight on his behalf, then he fights on our behalf. See, sometimes we get the war backwards. We think God's fighting our battles. No, he's fighting his battles in our life. Pretty big difference, huh? Come on, the Lord wants to know today, are you for us or against us? Come on. That's the Lord's question. The army of the angels. Whoo, Jesus. The fire of God's here. Yeah. Yo. Come on. Show. Yeah. Victory. The victory is the only outcome for those who fight on the Lord's behalf. Rather there's many or few, the Lord's going to bring victory.
Victory. In Jesus' name. Oh. In Jesus' name.
Hallelujah. Wow. Thank you, Jesus.